Can you light those candles up there on that mantel, setting the mood? Well, I just lie there staring, silently preparing to love on you. Well, I can feel the heat from across the room. Ain't it wild what a little flame can make you wanna do?
Good afternoon. My name is Bishop Wilson. We're gathered this afternoon to celebrate the wedding of Lacey Rice and Trenton McKaylee. I am officiating at the marriage and grateful to Lacey and Trent for the opportunity to perform their wedding ceremony. My family and the McKaylee family have been close friends for many years. The McKaylees used to live in our neighborhood prior to their move to their new home here last summer. I am the current bishop of the Heritage Fifth Ward in West Jordan. As you all know, Lacey and Trent wanted to be married on the ninth day of the ninth month in the year 09. I thought recently that if they really wanted to play this out the right way, they should have scheduled the wedding for this morning at 9:09. I have just a few words of counsel prior to proceeding into the actual marriage ceremony. A popular song when I was growing up was called United We Stand. The first words of the first line are, "United we stand, divided we fall, but if our back should ever be against the wall, we'd be together, together you and I." The scriptures have a word for being united in marriage, and that word is called cleave. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 24, it says, "Therefore shall a man leave his mother and father, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Cleave is an interesting word. Cleave means to adhere to cling to stick to, and to be faithful to. You will hear the word cleave mentioned later in the actual marriage ceremony. In an LDS Church Worldwide Leadership Training Conference I attended last year, the General President of the Primary, Cheryl C. Lant, made a profound observation regarding being united in marriage. She said, "Marriage is not so much about who's right, but what's right. From this moment on, you both should cleave to each other and only have eyes for each other and no one else." Elder Dallin H. Oaks of the Quorum of the 12 Apostles of the LDS Church has said regarding young married couples and being united, "I like to tell a young couple who are being married that in the marriage relationship, they ought to first look at one another, not first to their parents, not first to their siblings, not first to their friends, but in solving all of their problems, they should look first to one another. Don't get selfish. I think that if we were to look closely at marriages that fail, it is because one or both in the marriage get selfish. We all have hobbies or activities we like to do in our spare time. Lacey, you like to read and to make crafts and write poetry and draw. Trent, you like to go four-wheeling, watch movies, and work on cars. Make sure you both don't ever let those things come in front of or replace what is best for each other. Trent, you need to do whatever you can to make Lacey happy. And Lacey, you need to do whatever you can to make Trent happy. Remember that marriage is an alliance, not a surrender. If we were to compare marriage to the ocean, say in the Hawaiian Islands, the sea is usually calm right at sunset. As the sun goes down beyond the reef, it is thrilling and awe-inspiring. However, in those same beautiful islands, there are sometimes storms where it rains hard and the wind blows. Life is much like the islands. We all go through times when the seas are calm, when everything we look at or are doing is like a beautiful sunset. There are no waves. Then, for no apparent reason, the sky clouds over, the wind starts to howl, the sea has 20-foot waves, the ocean is almost black, and the night is dark. In the calm of the sunset and in the darkest storm, you will both need to take your Father in Heaven as part of your life. If you will do this, I promise you, your life will be smoother. Not that you won't have challenges, you will. But your ability to deal with the storms of life will be greater. Trent, your job is to provide and protect. Be the leader in your home. Treat Lacey and the children born to this union with love and respect. Lacey, your job is to nurture, not only the children, but Trent. It isn't easy as a man to go out and work hard day in and day out. Give him love, encouragement, and understanding. I know that if you will follow this counsel, you will have a successful marriage. Lacey and Trent, will you take each other by the right hand? Trenton Harrison McKaylee and Lacey Marie Rice, you have taken one another by the right hand in token of the covenant you will now enter into the presence of God and these witnesses. Trenton Harrison McKaylee, do you take Lacey Marie Rice as your lawfully wedded wife? And do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as her companion and lawfully wedded husband that you will cleave unto her and none else, that you will observe all the laws, covenants, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Lacey Marie Rice, do you take Trenton Harrison McKaylee as your lawfully wedded husband? And do you, of your own free will and choice, covenant as his companion and lawfully wedded wife, that you will cleave unto him and none else, that you will observe all the laws, covenants, and obligations pertaining to the holy state of matrimony, and that you will love, honor, and cherish him as long as you both shall live? By virtue of the legal authority vested in me as an elder in the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, I pronounce you, Trenton and Lacey, husband and wife, legally and lawfully wedded for the period of your mortal lives. May God bless your union with joy in your posterity and a long life of happiness together, and may He enable you to keep sacred the covenants you have made. These blessings I invoke upon you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may kiss each other as husband and wife. I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Trenton McKaylee. And I'd like to exchange rings at this time, so we'll go ahead and do that.